After two lengths of fencing are each secured at opposite ends, they can be stretched and spliced together. The two fencing ends should overlap at least 1 foot before they are stretched. Attach stretcher bars to each of the fencing ends, making certain every wire is held by a pin wedge. The bars should be at least 8 feet apart, but this distance may need to be more if the fencing is very slack or covers a very long distance. Next, connect 3 chain pullers between the 2 stretcher bars at the top, middle, and bottom. Make sure the chains are not twisted. Begin ratcheting all 3 chain pullers to start pulling the fence tight. Be cautious and make sure the claws of the chain puller are firmly seated on the chain when tightening. If the claws are not properly engaged, the puller's handle may fly back unexpectedly, causing injury. As the fence tightens and stretches, the temporary staples at the 5 or 6 foot height will begin to hit wire knots and restrict the stretching. Each staple will need to be checked, pulled out, and reset several times in the stretching process. Never put an extension on the chain puller lever to increase the leverage when pulling the fence tight. This can over-tighten the fence or damage and break the chain puller, injuring the people using it. Most fencing has bends in the horizontal wires. You can tell that the fence is stretched to the proper tension if half of this bend has been removed. Once the fence is stretched according to the fencing manufacturer's instructions, check that it is still 2 inches above the ground. Pound staples to secure the bottom 2 wires of the posts closest to the stretchers. The staples should be set at an angle to the right. Then work your way up the post, hammering in staples every other wire, so at least 8 wires are stapled. The top 2 wires should be stapled too, so you have a total of 12 wires stapled. Don't drive the staples tight. The wire should be able to slide under the staples. This allows the fence wire to expand and contract with temperature changes. Repeat this on every brace and line post. You can delay the stapling at each post if you have a crew available only for a short time. This final stapling can be completed by one person. Now it's time to complete the fence splice. Begin by removing only the center chain puller. Leave the other 2 pullers in place. The preferred method for connecting the wires of the 2 sections is to crimp splice them using crimping sleeves. Start by cutting the ends of the 2 fence sections so that there are 10 to 12 inch loose ends of wire from each section that are overlapping. Thread 1 long or 2 short crimping sleeves over the corresponding wires from each fence section. Be sure to straighten the bends in each wire to allow the crimping sleeves to slide easily back and forth. Now pull on the loose ends to remove slack and then bend the wire at right angles to the fence next to the crimp sleeves. This will prevent the wires from sliding out of the crimp sleeve. Use the crimping tool to crimp wires together 2 or 3 times on each sleeve. Repeat this procedure on each fence wire. Now trim off the excess wire at the crimp sleeve. An alternative for joining the 2 fence sections is to tie the wires together to make lap splices. With the chain pullers and stretcher bars still in place, cut off the ends of the 2 sections of fencing. Cut beside a wire knot so that there is a length of loose wire that reaches beyond a knot on the other section of fencing. Do this for all wires on the ends of both sections of fencing. Tie these loose wires around each matching wire on the opposite fencing section, just beyond the wire knot. Use a wire twisting tool, an electric wire twister, or the simple wrap hand tying method to make at least 4 wraps around the wire. Break off or trim off the extra wire. Now that the 2 fencing sections are spliced together, you can release and remove the chain pullers and stretcher bars. If you've skipped stapling the wires at each brace and line post, or tying off the wires at the corner posts, you should make sure this work is completed. Tie off each fence wire around the corner post using either hand or drill wire twisting tools. Do this for each wire of the fence.